Hello people, hello everyone. Welcome back to Trisha Nabo's channel. It is a privilege to be alive in the land of the living. I hope you are doing good. I hope you are fine. So please guys, this video today, like it, share it, and leave your comment for me, and as well subscribe if you haven't. If you are new to my channel, God bless you all for coming. I love you guys. I love you guys a lot. So in today's video, I'll be discussing my five lessons that I learned from the book of Job. And so, you know, in this lockdown season, it is a time for us to get closer, to study our Bible. So please, I encourage you to do same as well. Try your possible best. I know it is not easy to carry a book and be reading. There are a lot of stories in the book, so just locate one and read it with understanding and meditate on it, and God will bless us. Open up your mind to study the word of God. Don't let anyone tell you what is happening in the world today. Go through your Bible. The Bible will tell you what will happen, what has happened, and what you will see tomorrow. And you will see the Bible will probably tell you what you need to do in order not to be caught up with those things. So go through your Bible, you get to know this. So in this lockdown, I've gone through the book of Job, and so also I want you to try and go through it, and I pray that this little clip of mine also encourage you to do same. So I want to give you my little lesson that I learned from the book of Job. Many people read Bible, understand in different ways. God speaks to man in different ways, you understand? So this is how I got my own understanding. My five lessons that I learned from the book of Job. So please stay with me. Don't touch that dial. Watch to the end, all right? God bless you. Stay blessed. Wait for me. I'll be right back, all right? Welcome back, people. Thank you for staying. Thank you for watching. Please watch to the end. Like this video. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't, all right? So thank you so much. For your girl, God bless you. So let us get into the video without wasting more time. In this video, like I said earlier, that I'll be discussing the lessons I learned from the book of Job. And before I will get into the video proper, I want to introduce us to who Job is. I know we've heard about, we've been hearing about Job, and in the Bible, a man called Job, a super strong man in the faith, not by muscle, but by faith. So Job is a man from the land of Uz. He was a notable man, very rich, very famous. He had a lot of cattle, sheep, and workers, and sons and daughters were born to him. Of course, he has a wife. So Job was a prosperous man, and the devil came to the place of worship where the children of God came to offer praises to God. If you read Job chapter 1, that is where you get to see all this introduction and all that, who Job is, what he has, how God has blessed him, how many things he had. So let us go into the main thing, business of the video. So I want to say that number one thing that I learned from the book of Job, apart from chapter 1 that talks about the introduction, who Job was and all that, so I learned that faith is a paramount thing in the life of a Christian. Faith is what connects your heart to the heart of God. And many people have explained it in many ways, so I don't think I know how to explain the particular, but I can only explain the little I can. I am not a pastor, so even though we are all called to serve, so we are all servants of God. So faith is very, very important in the life of a Christian. And Job also portrayed this faith of a thing. He was a man full of faith. You know, we have fathers of faith. I believe if we start to mention those that their faith moved mountains, I think Job as well should be mentioned, because he also had faith. When you mention people like Abraham, all of them, they're all, you know, men of faith. So I think I should also mention Job as one of the men of faith, because he was a very an example of what faith is all about. The Bible said that without faith, it is impossible to please God. Have you seen anyone that pleased God without faith? I've never seen or I've never heard. So Job pleased God when it comes to faith. Job never relent. Job never faint in his faith. He was getting stronger, stronger, and stronger. Even when everyone cursed him or all manner of things, and that will even make one change his mind, he never lose faith in God. He was still trusting. He was not failed. He was still very, very consistent in faith. And one thing you should note about faith. Faith without work is actually dead. You know, you cannot say you have faith when you know you don't put it into practice. What is faith? Believing on those things that you have not seen, that they will come tomorrow. Something that is not in existence, but you believe that it is here already. That is what faith is. What you have not seen, you don't even know how it will come, but you've already believed it. That is what faith is. So Job believed God. He believed God for who God is, for what he can do, believed it for his words. They can never say a word and he will never bring it to pass. So Job was a man of faith. Number two, Job served God. Job served God. He served God even in pain. The Bible said that Job said, even if you slay me, I will never let you go. If you read chapter 19, please, I beg you to try and read chapter 19 of the book of Job. Read it from the beginning to the end. You will see how Job suffered. Even Job had to even drag this thing called flesh. He had to even drag that, say that even if worm comes out of this flesh, and which worm even came out of that flesh, at a point in his life, worms came out of his flesh. You could imagine such a servant. You know, he never failed serving God. He never failed, trusting God or believing God for what God can do. He was still serving God. There are times in our life when we go through difficulties, we remember God. Yes, we remember God only in difficult times. And that is it. We pray and cry and say, God, please help me. Then when God does that thing, we forget about God. But sometimes there are those that when it is time for trouble, they will forget about God. They will look for a fast miss. They will look for a miss to get out of any predicament they find themselves in. But Job never had any option. He trusted God. He was still serving God. Thank God. So please, wherever or whenever you find yourself in a difficult state, never you give up on. Maybe you have been serving God for many years, you've not gotten married, or you're not having an issue, or anything that you desire from God, he has not come forth. Never you give up on God, because when you are about to give up, that is when God takes control. Because I believe that the end of a man's strength, that is when God starts up his own strength. That is when God manifests his strength. Next one as well is that, what are the kind of friends that Job had? The kind of friends that Job had, they were not friends at all. They say, a friend in need is a friend indeed. Try to put yourself in your friend's shoe. Try to put yourself in other people's shoe. Don't always think, let it be you. Always feel people's pain. Feel people, as in feel their heartbeat at times. You know, they say, he that wears a shoe knows where it inches. It is true, but sometimes try to put yourself in other people's shoe and know how tight it is. Know the kind of pain they are going through. Just friends, they weren't friends indeed. They were just friends only by mouth, because the kind of words that they were pouring on Job, it was like, were they not around when Job was giving people thanks, as when he was doing almsgiving and all that? They were like, Job, you are a sinner. You are not a just man. Just confess to God. Just confess and he will forgive you. Friend, be a good friend. You never know who will be helping you tomorrow, or you never know people's condition. You can never determine the people's life, because people's lives are not in your hands. So also, you can't determine people's life. Learn to put yourself in someone's shoe and feel for others as well. Job's friends did not feel his pain. If they had felt his pain, the way they were following him up that time, they could have done better. So be a good friend. Therefore, you be a bad friend, a friend that will see a friend dying. You will, instead of you to render words that will heal their wounds, you are giving them words that join to their wounds. Even Job even mentioned it, that if he was in the shoe of his friends, that he would have spoken words that will help to heal their wounds. But what are they doing this to him? Job even asked them. When I caught the particular verse, I felt so pity for Job. I felt so bad for Job. Like, what kind of friends are these? And I believe we have such friends also in the world today. But four lessons that I learned from the book of Job is trust. If you must get something from God, never you lose your trust in Him. Never you lose your trust in Him. Always trust God for what He can say. The Bible said that instead of my word will come back to me in void, let the heaven and earth pass away. The word of God standeth sure. The word of God standeth secure. His word can never come back to Him void. So if God has promised you something, hold strong that word that God has promised you. Believe Him, knowing that He will surely come through for you when the appropriate time comes, just as He told Sarah and Abraham, that by this time, at the time of life, believing that time will come, always believe God, because He knows the time. He knows the best time for you. You will not tell God the time that you want something. You only say, God, let your will be done, because God wish us good, not evil. So God always knows the best thing for us. You may not know the best thing for yourself, but God knows it. So always trust Him, alright? And the last but not the least of my number five today, before I wrap up this video, it is forgiveness. 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 A lot of people have preached about forgiveness. I myself, I still pray every day for the Spirit to forgive, because there are times somebody will hurt you. For you to forgive them, you will like. But when you remember that God died for you, when you think about that God died for you, you will have every reason to forgive somebody even before that anger cools down. You will even forgive them before that anger cools down. So if you understand the benefits of forgiveness, you will know, because anyone you hold in your heart, you do not forgive that person. You are not just doing that person alone. You are also doing to yourself, because holding somebody in your heart hinders a lot of blessings to you. So, no matter how someone offends you, learn to forgive. I learned that one very well, very well in the book of Job. Job forgave his friends. And when he forgave, what happened to him? God blessed him times two of what he had. If he had 6,000 flocks, God increased it. If he has 3,000 flocks, sheep and all that, God increased them. Those things that we are 7, we are doubled times 2 and it became 14. Those things that we are 3, we are doubled times 2 become 3. So God doubled everything that He had. So there is always a gift behind every forgiving soul. Learn to forgive somebody. It is not easy, and you can never do it by your flesh. You only go to God. God, please give me the heart. Give me the heart to forgive this boy, to forgive this girl, to forgive this woman, this aunt, this uncle, whoever they may be, and whatever they have matter. I've done to you. Learn to forgive people for your own sake. You understand? For your own sake, so that you won't miss heaven. You might do all manner of things. You might do everything you could do. Be the perfect man and the most righteous man. If you don't have forgiveness in your heart, you will miss it. You will miss it. Someone tells you to do something of 100 things, and you did 99.9. You miss only 1 cent. That 1 cent that you miss will destroy you, will end your life. So let us learn to forgive somebody. I know it is not easy, but you cannot do it by your flesh. You only ask God to help you. And I pray, as you ask God today for the grace to forgive, I pray that you will receive the grace to forgive whoever that offended you, all right? The best way you can forgive someone that offended you is by you praying for them. Learn to pray for someone that offended you. Learn to pray for them, and you will see yourself forgiving them, loving them, all right? So do it, and you see it will work. Anyone that hurt you so badly that you sworn never to forgive that person, just try and pray and say, God, please, I want to forgive this person. Give me the grace, all right? And you pray that prayer today. Tomorrow, your mind will start to melt. Your anger will begin to go down. And the next day you pray, God, please bless this person. You know what that person what is believing God for. Pray for that person in that line. If it is maybe to get a job, for instance, you say, God, please bless this my father. Bless this my auntie. This my uncle. Bless her. Give her what she wants. By so doing, you are releasing that those anger. It is a gradual process. Then before you not take your phone and say hello or send message, you know, it starts gradually, and I pray as we do so, God will bless us. Thank you so much, guys, for always being with me. And if you watch to this point, and God bless you, I really appreciate you. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. See you guys in my next video. Until then, stay safe, stay blessed, and keep loving. All right, keep loving. I will see you soon. Ciao, ciao. See you soon.